Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the controllability and observability of a discrete data system. So already we know that what is controllability and observability. Okay, and now we are going to solve the problem based on the controllability and observability. Okay, and before going to this, first we should know that why we check this controllability and observability for the discrete data system. Okay. So, in order to design a straight feedback controller, the first condition is your system, it should be straight controllable. Then only you will be able to design a straight feedback controller for a particular process. Similarly, for observability, if you want to design a straight observer for a particular process, then you should know that how to check the observability, and your observability value, it should not be equivalent to zero. Then only your system is completely straight observable. Okay, so the first condition for design of straight observer and straight feedback controller is your system, it should be in a straight controllable and observable. Okay, so they are given a problem statement like this. Okay, so take down the problem statement. Consider a system with this straight equation given below, with this straight matrix given below. A value 0, minus 2, 1, minus 3, B value 1, 1, and C value equal to 0, 1. Okay? Check the controllability and observability for the same. Okay? So listen. So first step for controllability. So this is your condition to check the controllability. QC equal to BAB, A to the power n minus 1 into B. So what is this n means? That is your order of the matrix A. So here your order of the matrix A is a 2. So that's why here QC equal to BAB alone. Okay, so your condition for controllability is your determinant of QC should not be equal to 0. Okay, so that's why here first I need to write only this values of B matrix and next one AB. So already you know that matrix multiplication. Okay. So AB value now we find out minus 2 minus 2. Okay. So now the determinant of QC value is 0. So it shows that your system is not state controllable. Okay, similarly, you need to check the observability. So for observability, determinant of Q naught, it should not be equal to 0. So how will you find out your Q naught? Similarly, Q naught equal to C transpose, A transpose, C transpose, A transpose, the whole power 1 into C transpose. Okay, here also again your order of the matrix is a 2. So C transpose, A transpose into C transpose. Okay, so already you know that what is A transpose. A transpose means that just exchanging your rows into column and vice versa. So A transpose means 0 minus 2, 1 minus 3. And what is your C transpose?
0,
1. So now I'm going to give 1 minute talk. Okay, within a minute you need to check the observability for the given process. Okay, check the observability. Within a minute you have to give an answer for me. Just solve it. Those who have completed the problem, solve it on the board. Yes, have you all got the answer?
Yes.
Have you all got the same answer?
Yes. Yes.
So now you should know. Now you know that.
Thank you.
So now from this problem statement, we know that what is controllability and how to check the controllability, and what is observability and how to check the observability. Okay. So in this statement, your system, that is the determinant of QC value is zero. That's why your system is not state controllable. But here your determinant of Q0 value equal to 1, that's why your system is said to be the observable state, completely observable. Based on this controllability and observability only, your next step is you need to design a state observer and